my learning cluster is titled A Learning Cluster on Learning Clusters, because one of the things that we are trying to do at Veritex is to kind of shift the culture around learning. And so what we'd like for folks to understand and take away is that they have multiple options in how to go about their learning, and they have the autonomy to choose which learning assets they want to utilize. And so when I say knowledge of what a learning cluster is in my SPO, I don't mean necessarily understanding specifically the term learning cluster and all the terminology that we use in this session, but just understanding the concept of how you can access multiple learning assets and find the ones that fit your needs. So my SPO is by improving the knowledge of what a learning cluster is and how it functions for Veritex employees, SMEs, and managers. The business will benefit by utilizing L&D resources effectively to create learning assets that are useful to employees and having more engaged employees who seek out learning when they need it. So the on-the-job behaviors that I focus on, a lot of them have to do with access and kind of the actions that we want folks to take around the learning assets that we create. So proactively accessing learning assets that fit their needs, choosing which learning assets to utilize rather than just doing what is mandatory or assigned to them, recommending L&D provided learning assets to colleagues and or direct reports, and reaching out to L&D to help develop learning assets early in the development process rather than waiting until late in the development process. That one refers specifically to our SMEs. My personas that I have no time Tim. Tim feels that he has no time for training, even though he does have some level of discretionary time, and is generally not interested in L&D provided content as he doesn't see the connection to his day-to-day work. So what we're hoping for no time Tim is that he starts to see which assets are relevant to him and starts to become more of a promoter of the L&D content that we're providing. Manager Martha manages a regional team and does not like to waste time. Her overall approach to learning is skepticism, and she has a little bit of like a prove it kind of attitude. So she'll promote learning assets to her team if she sees value in them. But so far, she hasn't been a champion of learning at the company. So we're looking to kind of get Martha on board and see if we can demonstrate value in what we're providing so that she can become a promoter of our learning assets to her team. And then we have Champion Charlie. So he's one of our SMEs. He loves to learn and create learning assets. He has served as an SME and content creator for L&D in the past, and he's very motivated to learn and excited to try new things. He has an open-minded, enthusiastic, and positive attitude about learning. So Charlie is the one that we'd like to have promoting what we're doing and also helping encourage other SMEs to reach out to L&D early in the development process. That's what he's doing already. Looking at the learning, there's nothing to upgrade because this is a brand new concept for us. So nothing for the upgrade action, but looking at the learning assets that I'd like to create for this learning cluster. So firstly, I'm referencing the learning cluster on the new LMS that Danielle was just describing, because one of the ways that I'd like for folks to understand this new concept around how to learn and how learning functions is to actually experience it. And so by experiencing the learning cluster on the new LMS, that will help people to understand what we're getting at. Other assets that I want to highlight would be an email campaign to manager Mary, letting her know what assets are available and what we're developing. Informal mentorship where Champion Charlie can support other SMEs in their efforts to create learning assets, and a discussion forum where No Time Tim can share what he's learning and potentially recommend assets to other colleagues if he finds them that he likes. So tracking transformation, L&D being brought on earlier in the process of learning asset development is something we'd like to track. Improvement in the SME's ability to imagine and create non-traditional learning assets, so learning assets that are beyond just a course. 50% of learners accessing an optional course per quarter, increasing the number of employees who report accessing L&D provided learning assets when they need to learn something. So doing a survey of where folks are going when they need to learn something. And then having 75% of managers report promoting at least one L&D provided learning asset to their teams per quarter.